Hello and welcome back to Decimal Learning Series. Today's topic is Mastering Division of Decimals. The key terms to remember in division of decimals: dividend, the number being divided; divisor, the number we divide by; quotient, the result of the division; remainder, the part left undivided. In this lesson, we will explore 6 types of decimal division. So, without any further delay, let's get started. First is division of decimals by models. So, for that, let us take a very simple example, 0.6 divided by 3. Take a square which is divided into 10 strips. Each strip represents 0.1. Out of this, color 6 in red color. And so when you divide these 6 strips in 3 parts, we get here 2. 2 times 3 is 6. So the answer is 0.2. Next is division of decimal by whole number. Case 1, divisor smaller than dividend. We'll take an example, 12.5 divided by 5. Here 12.5 is the dividend and 5 is the divisor, which is smaller than the dividend. As usual, you write it 12.5 divided by 5. Now, dividing a decimal by a whole number is the same process as dividing whole numbers, where you use the method how many times, multiply, subtract, bring down and repeat. Now, here in this particular case, 5 will go in 12 how many times? 2 times. And then next step is 5 times 2, multiply, you get 10. Then the third step is subtract, 12 minus 10 is 2. And then before you bring down, because it is decimal, you have to place the decimal point directly above the decimal point in the dividend. The place value is maintained throughout the division, so you can simplify it just like regular division. You bring down 5. So we get 25, and then 5 will go in 25 5 times, then 5 times 5 is 25, subtract, you get 0. Remember, decimal needs to appear only in the dividend and the quotient. 12.5 divided by 5 is 2.5. Now let us take case 2, divisor greater than dividend. 0.75 divided by 3. Now the divisor is 3 and it is greater than 0.75. Arrange it as before and the same principle, HMSB. How many times? Now here it is 0.75, so you have to place the decimal above the dividend. Now 0 will remain 0. You place a decimal and then 3 will go in 7 2 times. So you have 7 minus 6, that is 1. Bring down 5, 15. 3 will go in 15 5 times. And 3 times 5 is 15. Subtract and you get 0. So the answer here is 0.75 divided by 3 is 0.25. You can check the answer by multiplying divisor and the quotient. You have to get the dividend. Next is division of decimal by decimal. This is the fourth type of division. Let us take an example, 0.4 divided by 0.02. Here we are going to use fractions because you know that fractions and decimals, they go hand in hand. So 0.4 divided by 0.02. You multiply the numerator by 100. Why? Because in the denominator, it has two places of decimal and in the numerator, there is only one place. So you have to multiply the numerator and the denominator by 100. So when you do 0.4 times 100, you get 40. Then 0.02 times 100 will give you 2. Therefore, this becomes 40 by 2. And 40 by 2, you know, is equal to 20. Next is division of whole number by a decimal. 2 divided by 0.4. We'll convert this as a fraction. 2 divided by 0.4. Now, since it has only one place of decimal in the denominator, you multiply both the numerator and the denominator by 10. 2 times 10 is 20. 0.4 times 10 is 040. When you put a decimal, it will become 4. So this comes out to be 20 by 4, which is equal to 5. We'll take another example and we'll try to do using long division method. 42 divided by 0.7. Write it as usual. Since there is a decimal in the divisor, you have to remove that decimal. So since it is only one place, you have to multiply by 10 the divisor as well as the dividend. So when you multiply, 0.7 will become 7 and 42 will become 420. 7 will go in 42 how many times? 6 times. Then multiply 7 times 6. Then subtract. There is one 0 here, so bring down that 0. And 7 will go in 0 how many times? 7 goes into 0, 0 times. So you have to write 0 in the quotient. And therefore, the answer is 60. 42 divided by 0.7 is equal to 60. Next is division of decimals when remainders appear. We have already covered terminating and non-terminating decimals. You can check out for the link in the description and watch the video again. Now, when we divide decimals, we do not show the remainders. We add extra zeros to complete the division. Writing an extra zero in the dividend does not change the value of the dividend. For example, 7.5 divided by 2. Write it as usual, 7.5 divided by 2. 2 is a whole number. You can check how many times 2 goes in 7. It goes 3 times. And 2 times 3 is 6. Then subtract 1. You have to place the decimal in the quotient just above the decimal in the dividend. And then bring down 5 and you get 15. 2 doesn't go exactly in 15. So we can take here 7 and 2 times 7 is 14. And when you subtract, you get 1. Here 1 is the remainder, so you have to add one 0 after 5 and bring down that 0 and you get here 10. Now 2 will go in 10 how many times? 5 times. So 2 times 5 is 10, subtract, you get 0. Therefore the answer is 7.5 divided by 2 is 3.75. Now the last type, division of decimals when the divisor is 10, 100, 1000 and so on. For that, we'll take one example. You have to divide 7 by 10. The simplest way is move the decimal point one place to the left. So we get here 0.7. Second example, 7 divided by 100. Same way, you have to move the decimal point two places to the left. 1, 2, and then you have to add one extra 0, so you get here 0.07. Now the third one, 7 divided by 1000, same way you have to move the decimal point 3 places to the left, 1, 2, 3, so you will have to add 2 extra zeros and we get the answer 0.007. Now the last part, let us try to do word problems. Ria is skipping while her friends Ryan and Jai hold the skipping rope. In 4.5 minutes, Ria completes 36 skips. If she maintains the same pace, how many skips does she complete per minute? To find the number of skips per minute, we have to divide the total skips by the total time. So 36 divided by 4.5. 36 is the dividend and 4.5 is the divisor. As we had done before, it will become 45 and inside it will become 360. And 45 times 8 is 360 and therefore the answer is 8. So Ria completes 8 skips per minute. A large water dispenser contains 22.5 liters of water. If each small bottle can hold 1.5 liters, how many small bottles can be completely filled. To find the number of bottles, divide the total water volume by the capacity of one bottle, that is 22.5 divided by 1.5. You can do this division. Now, since both are having only one place of decimal, it is same as 225 divided by 15, and you know that 15 times 15 is how much? 225. So 15 bottles can be completely filled with water. Congratulations on completing the decimal learning series. Today's topic was the last topic in decimal learning series. You have learned all the key concepts of decimals, from understanding the basics to multiplying and dividing decimals. Keep practicing to master these skills. Let me know in the comments which topic you would like to learn next. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for the next video. Goodbye and good luck.